for Dr. Pepper, here's Y&T.
Rock and roll is for the kids, it's for everybody. It's an attitude more than anything else, and some people just don't understand that. But we're all down here together to show that we care just as much as everybody else does about famine and people that are in trouble and need our help. And we know that we can do our part and make it worthwhile. And we're all here, and it's like one happy family. It's great. It's a good vibe down here.
Everyone, this is Dave Menichetti from Y&T. I just wanted to call attention to some of our extended family up in the Santa Cruz Mountains that were hit with a devastating fire a couple of months ago, ripped through the region and created a lot of devastation. There's a campaign called Love You Madly that is accepting funds for the Santa Cruz fire relief. And I would just encourage all of you that if you have a couple of bucks that you could share with the Santa Cruz fire relief, that would be much appreciated. These people need a lot of help, and anything you can do to help, of course, would be a fantastic thing. Cheers, everyone. You know I want you. I want you to rescue me. Whoa, rescue me. Oh, you know I want you. I want you to rescue me. Whoa, rescue me. And now I'm going to played a little video from last year in the fall, just outside of Paris, a song called Black Tiger. Cheers, everyone. Please help if you can.
San Francisco Hot Rock with Rick Springfield, The Cars, Rockwell, Billy Idol, The Curly Shuffle, Vintage Weird Al Yankovic, and a visit with Bay Area Rockers Y&T.
Welcome to San Francisco Hot Rock. I'm Steve Garland. This week we're at Fantasy Recording Studios in Berkeley, where the Bay Area's own Y&T are busy recording their new LP. Fantasy is best known for Creedence Clearwater Revival, but most recently groups like Journey, the Greg Kinn Band, Huey Lewis and the News have all recorded albums here at Fantasy's state-of-the-art facilities. We're going to take you inside Studio D for a visit with the Bay Area's own Y&T as they work on new tracks for their LP, plus more of your favorite hot rock videos along the way. Here we are inside Studio D at Fantasy Recording in Berkeley. This is the room where a lot of hit records have been made. It's also the room where local rockers Y&T are hoping to make a few hits of their own. They're in the midst of recording their fourth album for A&M Records, and in a bit we'll talk to Dave Menichetti, lead vocalist and guitarist for the group, about what it takes to get to album number four. Well, album number five has just been released from The Cars. It's called Heartbeat City. After a long break, almost 2 years since their last album, Rick Ocasek and the group have come up with some of their best work. Their first single and video is this week's Hot Rock Pick Hit. Now, I think it's going to go all the way to the top. You judge for yourself. We've got the new video from The Cars, plus Huey Lewis, and more from Fantasy Recording with Y&T coming up.
Billy Idol and the Mean Streak Behind Y&T coming up next.
Well, it's break time for Y&T, the Bay Area Zone. They're in the middle of recording their fourth album for A&M Records here at Fantasy Studios. And with us is Dave Menichetti, lead guitarist and vocalist for the group.
What's happening, Steve?
Hey, it's good to see you, Dave. You know, a lot of groups claim to be Bay Area bands, but a lot of them have moved here from other cities. They're not homegrown. You grew up right here. Well, not right here, but in the East Bay. And that's where Y&T began. How long ago was that?
10 years ago. Ten years ago. We're all born and raised in Oakland.
In Oakland.
We're bad boys, that's right.
What songs are you guys working on today?
Working on Breakout Tonight and on a few others. Probably the ballad, a few other tunes today.
Mm-hmm. Last year you did your album Mean Streak and the group did their first music video. Are you planning one for this album?
Absolutely.
You have an idea which one?
Well, we've been trying to decide, but we're in a good situation here where we don't know which one's going to be the single because there's a lot of chances for singles on this record, so it's not decided yet.
Mm-hmm. How many steps do you take as Y&T from the beginning of a written song all the way to the finished product when you're working on an album? What steps do you take?
Well, usually we spend about 2 months writing for the record ahead of time. We get together in the rehearsal studio, just start coming up with licks, things that maybe we've worked on when we were touring or something, you know, and an idea that came up or whatever, or some stuff that was left from the last record that we didn't use. And then we just start working on it. Somebody will come in with a lick, it'll spend all day long just trying to build a song on it. And then it gets to the point where you've got the melodies and everything, and then you start working on the lyrics. And of course, you bring in your producer, you do some pre-production on the record, make sure that all the parts are in the right places, come in and cut it.
You do play a lot of concerts and club dates in other countries and here in America. What is the single most embarrassing thing that's ever happened to Y&T on stage?
Probably at the old Waldorf a couple of years ago, Phil split his pants wide open for about 150 girls in front of him to see everything about Phil that they always wanted to see. And he had to change his pants, of course, behind his amplifier stacks in between tunes.
And the band had to keep playing.
Oh, of course. We don't miss a trick. We're professionals, right?
A taste of Y&T's new album, captured live on San Francisco Hot Rock. I'm Steve Garland. When we return, it's time for comedy videos. We've got two in a row guaranteed to put a smile on your face. The Curly Shuffle and Weird Al's Ricky.
Bay Area group Y&T is working on their new album here at Fantasy Recording Studios. The LP should be out in a few months, so watch for it. We'll also be looking forward to premiering their next video right here on San Francisco Hot Rock. We've got Eddie Money's latest video for you next.
If you haven't picked up your San Francisco Hot Rock sticker yet, what are you waiting for? They're available at 7-Eleven stores throughout the Bay Area, but there is a limited supply, so grab one soon at your 7-Eleven and stick it. Well, that's all for this week's show. Our thanks to Fantasy Studios and the Bay Area's own Y&T. You guys ready for a great surprise? Look what I brought with me. I'm all suited up. I'm ready to go. What do you think? Can I join the band for a few tracks?
Dave? Sorry, Steve.
Yeah, Steve.
No, no, really. I'm
I heard
a guitar player.
What?
No, Trevor. I know Mean Streak by heart.
Hey.
No,
all right.
I'm Steve Garland. See you next week. Leonard, one song.
No way, man. Get a
one
job.
One song. One song. Come on.
No
please.
Way.
One song. One half a song. 3 months. No way.
If you want me, let me know. If you want me, just say so. If you want me, baby, I will be with you. Now, if you're lonely and you need someone, I'll be waiting to take a chance if you want me. Oh, I'll be there with you. Well, if it all turns out wrong, no, it just don't feel right. If it all turns out wrong, at least we know we tried to fill this emptiness that burns inside. If you want me, call my name. I'll be waiting. I feel the same. So if you want me, baby, just let me know. Oh, if you want me, baby, let me know. If you need me, baby, let it show. If you want my love, baby, I'll be with you. Turns out wrong. No, it just don't feel right. If it all turns out wrong, at least we know we tried to fill this emptiness that burns inside. Oh, if you want me, baby, let me know. If you need me, come on, let it show. 'Cause if you want my love, I will be with you. Oh, if you're lonely, oh, you need someone, I'll be waiting. Just let it all come undone. If you want me, you need me, you know I will be with you.
Rockers in America, we're Y&T. We're hanging out backstage, the Oakland Coliseum. Big day on the Green Show, Scorpions, Rat, Y&T, Metallica. It's going to be an incredible show. But right now, I just have this incredible opportunity to introduce you, that's right, America, to our friend and friendly mascot,
Rock.
Rock. So we figure since he's such one of the boys, you know, maybe he can, like, take over some of our interview chores, you know, because, you know, we're on the road getting burnt out. Maybe he can, like, take over. So, Rock, I'm going to get you primed for this, all right? You ready? So I figure, you know, let's see how you handle yourself with the press. Like, if the press comes up and says, what about that new album coming out called Down for the Count in October? What are you going to say?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, we're having. And what about that hot new video coming out? What's that going to be like?
Yeah.
Hey, Rock, man, I want to tell you. Speaking of videos, man, in the video awards, they don't have a category for robots, and you are the baddest robot in video,
but we got something for Rock.
We do have something for Rock. We have.
The Melvin!
The Melvin.
Just for you, Rock.
Yeah.
Our favorite robot in a supporting and leading role in a video.
Now you too can see him on MTV right now.
Yeah.
What it be? This is Y&T.
Stick around for some more heavy metal videos on Heavy Metal Mania.
Yeah.
Salute.
We'll be right back. Back in the hazier days of my youth, Y&T was a legend among rock and roll bands. I know I've been to several of their concerts, but I don't remember it, which means I had a very good time. They performed all over the globe. They opened for acts like Ozzy Osbourne and AC/DC. We are so glad to have Y&T frontman Dave Menichetti here to show us how he uses computers to make music. Dave, I got to shake your hand and bow down
versa.
To you.
It's
vice so
versa.
Nice to meet you.
You're my hero.
Oh, no, it's quite the opposite. I'm really thrilled to have you in. When Bill here told me that you actually watch the show once in a while, I was very pleased.
That's more than
how long have you been playing guitar?
I started when I was 16, which is kind of late for
that
a lot
late,
of guitar players.
Because I have a 9-year-old son, and I'm saying, he play the guitar, play the guitar. And so 16, huh?
16, but I was a fast learner.
Yeah.
I got a record deal when I was 20.
Wow, that's cool.
And I've been touring and making records for 30 years.
Do you love it?
Yes, I do.
Yeah. It's really, what a great thing to be able to do.
I was off the road for a couple of years in the 90s, and my life was hell.
Yeah. So you like the performance?
I actually do.
I can't do. I have to do stuff in front of people.
That's
my
right.
wife says I won't even have a conversation unless 20 people are listening. I don't know if that's true. So the things have changed quite a bit though in that time in recording. Your first album, I'm sure, recorded in a traditional studio.
Traditional
right?
studio, analog tape. Yes.
Cost hundreds of dollars an hour to use.
That's right.
Recording studios had to fork over big bucks to make those.
That's
albums.
Right.
Now you can do it at home.
That's right.
Is it as good?
It is.
Really?
It really is. You have to know what you're doing. I mean, really it comes down to engineering.
You're a sound engineer now and a producer as well as a performer.
That's right.
You have to be all of
Yeah, you have to be.
Yeah. But is that fun for you? You like it?
I love it.
Show us what this...
I'm a geek, you know.
You're a geek. You like the gadgets.
I love to tweak with everything.
So you brought... And I have to say, I'm thrilled that you must have had a hand truck and about four roadies because you brought a ton of stuff here.
My wife helped me, roadie.
Thank you. This is stuff from your home recording studio.
Yes. Actually, I borrowed the CPU from Central Computer, but they make all of my CPU...
You just don't want to pull it out of the rack.
Exactly. Yeah. And this is a rack mountable unit. And
well, we're going to get to the. Let's go in order. Start with the FireWire audio card.
Sure. I mean, generally speaking, you want to get a good quality audio card.
So you don't have one in the computer?
You can have one in the computer, but generally speaking, if you have one in the computer, it's usually got a breakout cable to a box.
Right.
Because when you're in the studio, you don't want to be
reaching back.
Computer. Right. You want all the stuff up front. This is FireWire. This makes it really easy. You don't even have to get inside your computer and put a card in, worry about interrupts or anything like that.
M-Audio is the name of it.
M-Audio, M-Audio actually is one of the best companies out there for sound cards right now because... They keep their drivers current, and they're really
very important.
And
now, one of the advantages also getting the sound card out of the box is you don't have all the electrical interference that's inside the box.
Yeah.
So a lot of people say it's cleaner to get if you can get a digital output as you do with FireWire and have all of the analog to digital stuff.
Analog
happening.
To digital and digital to analog conversions are done outside the box.
Yeah.
That's always better.
Now I like these speakers. We were listening, and this sounds like we're at a concert here, and they're just tiny little speakers. What are these?
These are also from M-Audio, and they're their little 5-inch. Satellite speakers, and I also brought their subwoofer down here, and it's a nice little combo, and somewhere in the range of $500 for the whole thing.
You're kidding?
No.
And
you can really hear what's happening when you're recording and mixing and so on and so forth.
What makes a good speaker? What are you as a musician and a recording artist looking for in a speaker?
Well, generally speaking, we say that we're looking for accuracy. You know, we want things to sound...
You don't want the bass to be too loud.
Right, exactly. I mean, when you're in your studio, you're trying to get everything to sound pretty even, because when you're mixing... If you have too much bass, like you have your subwoofer turned up,
you'll
too
mix
high,
it wrong.
You're going to mix it wrong.
It'll be
all
too
of your
low.
Mixes are going to sound like they're bass shy.
Right.
Because
you thought you had more.
Right.
Yeah. What's the Pod XT Pro?
The Pod XT Pro is this red thing. Now, basically, if you're a guitar player and you're wanting to record at home, you're going to really have problems with your neighbors if you have a Marshall stack and you're just turning it up.
Because you want that big stadium sound.
That's
baby.
It. Absolutely. Yeah. And this really does it for you. It's a great tool, especially for songwriting and everything like that. It models amplifiers. So in other words, maybe it's got a model of a Marshall stack or a Boogie
or a
Fender or something like that. And you can choose between those. You can choose between different types of cabinets, like a 412 cabinet or a 212. And you can even choose your own microphone. What microphone do you like to record?
It'll model a microphone.
It'll
so you can use any
model
mic.
A microphone. Well, they have certain microphones in here, like a 421 or a 57.
But you use a Shure mic here, and then you can have it be any mic coming out.
Exactly.
There.
And then you can even pull it further away from the cabinet or right next to the speaker. You know, it's all modeled. And they give you effects, delay, chorus, things like that. So it's an all-in-one kind of thing.
And these are all digital effects now. I mean,
digital
this
effects.
Is all computer modeled and everything.
Yeah.
And as you mentioned down here, the piece PC that puts it all together. And it's a PC. I mean, it's running Windows,
it's a PC.
Right?
Yeah, exactly.
Let's show some of the software that's running.
Sure. What I've got up on right now is Cubase. Now, this is from a company, Steinberg, that I use their top-of-the-line product, or at least their most expensive product. It's hard to say top-of-the-line anymore because Cubase and Nuendo, which is the product I use a lot for making records, too, they're both very, very similar. They have similar features.
I'm going to take a break, and when we come back, I want you to show us, because you recorded your latest solo album on this program. In fact, that's what we're looking at right now.
Mm-hmm.
Wait till you hear this, folks. It's amazing, all by yourself, what you can do, multi-track recording.
That's right.
That just sounds great. When we come back, more with Dave Menichetti, the frontman for Y&T. We're having a lot of fun here. We're going to hear some rock and roll, too, and just rock on right after this. Stay here. What hall is that we're playing in? Are we in Wembley Stadium here?
We're in the Call for Help Hall.
We got Dave Menichetti here from Y&T, and he's showing us how musicians, pros even now, are using standard PCs and standard software to do their music. Now, of course, some of this stuff is not standard, like the M-Audio sound card, but you could do a lot of this stuff with your existing home PC.
Absolutely.
And this software, of course, is off-the-shelf software, Cubase.
Right.
So is this a multi-track recording program?
It is indeed. You want to use this for just about anything that you want to do, including coming up with ideas. In fact, typically what I do when I'm songwriting for a new record, I'll just open up a track for the vocal and a track for my guitar, and I'll be sitting in my studio by myself, and I'll just be recording myself and coming up with ideas on the spot.
And if you like it, you got it.
If I like it, I've got it, exactly. And I know how to access it real quickly, and I can add drums and bass to it later or whatever I want to
do. Now, you play all the instruments on here?
I don't. In this particular instance, I have my band playing with me. What we've got up here, all this gray stuff, this is all the drums.
I've got, look at that.
Everything separate.
So you might
keep
drums separately.
A snare, a hat, and, yeah, exactly.
You can also use a program, and I know you do like Acid, it's called Acid, that allows you to kind of take other people's sampled music and put it in. So you could use that to kind of try ideas as well.
Yeah, I use Acid a lot, actually, for songwriting. It's a great idea.
You don't need to bring the band in.
Exactly, yeah. You've got samples of drums, bass, keyboards, anything that you want, and you can start crafting a song before you even play a note.
What's the name of this song?
This one's called Storm. And
so this is your, is this down here at the bottom, that's the guitar
this
solo?
This is a guitar solo, and what I thought I'd do is I'd show how you can use this, once you've got your basic track. When they say basic track, they mean bass and drums, basically.
Yeah.
Is what they
the
mean.
Rhythm in the background.
The rhythm in the background.
Yeah.
And this is how most records are done, and then after that, everybody comes in and they put their parts over the top of
that. That's typically how it's done. They lay down the bass and drum, and then one at a time, each musician comes in.
That's right. It's like, oh, it's bass day, he's going to go through do all his bass again.
Right.
Okay, now it's guitar day, now it's vocals, and background vocals and so on and so forth. So you come in, and the great thing about doing it with this type of software is, and it's also a bad thing, it's a good and a bad, it depends on how much you overuse it, I should say, is the fact that you can just keep going over and over and trying a bunch of different takes.
Change it.
And they can do what's called comping. In other words, if I did 10 takes of one song singing, they go in there now and they've got all 10 takes lined up, and you can I'll take just this word from this take, this word from that, and you just make this one performance out of it.
Saves you time.
It does.
Can you also change the tempo? Can you change the key? You can do all of that too.
You can. You can even slip things in, like if somebody played it maybe a little faster than it should be, you can just take that one thing and compact it in size. I mean, it's really what we used to think was a cheater way of doing it, but if you're a real musician, you want to get your soul
in it.
It
saves you some time.
You want to get your soul in
it
first.
That's right. You want to get it right. Yeah. Well, but that's why sometimes the bands nowadays can't perform live, because they never did perform live.
Right.
Bands like Y&T started
live.
We
can actually play.
And you actually can play. Hey, let's show them how you would dub in the rest of that guitar solo.
So basically, this blue right here, this is the guitar solo, and I basically muted the second half so I could say, okay, well, I didn't really like the second half when I did it. I open up a new track. I don't have to, but I do in this instance, and I've got it ready to go. And all you do to hit record is just hit the asterisk key in Cubase or Nuendo, and you're ready to go. So I'm just going to hit play, and then I'm going to hit record and start playing along.
Dave Menichetti from his solo album. This is Storm. Let's see.
Wow. And then there it is.
Oh,
it comes
man,
up on the
recorded.
Screen. It's done. It's done.
And then, you know, I brought, you know, I just thought maybe I brought some of my own instruments because I believe that I have some rock and roll talent. So if you ever needed some percussion, I could just... Hey, by the way, your wife, your wonderful wife, Jill, is sitting there. And we thank you, Jill, for being here and helping Dave schlep all his stuff over here. And does she put up with all of this gadget stuff? You know?
Yes, she does.
She's a very nice person.
Actually, she's one of the rare wives that I have these giant, you know, humongous speakers in my front room. And it's like, bigger's better.
That's a wife. She's a keeper. That's absolutely wonderful. That's wonderful. Dave, it's been so much fun seeing you play and seeing what you use in your home studio to make music. You guys are performing right now. In fact, I know you're going to be up in Petaluma in a little bit.
We'll
you're playing
in
Anaheim.
We're playing Anaheim House of Blues tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Yeah. Yeah. And any albums you want to tell
us about? I'm working on my next solo record, and Y&T has got a new record coming out, which is previously unreleased material.
Wow. Oh, that's great.
Because we've been playing for so long, we've written all these great songs, we demoed them up, and a lot of people haven't had a chance to hear them.
What's the name of that?
Unearthed.
Volume 1. Y&T, Volume 1. There may be Volume 2.
There will
two.
Be more.
If you want to learn more. And by the way, listen for the great bongo playing. No. If you want to learn more about turning your PC into a home recording studio, surf on over to our website, techtv.com/call for help. Dave Menichetti, great to meet you. Thank
absolute
you so
pleasure
much
to
for
be
being here.
Here.
Can you just a little something to take us out?
Sure, absolutely.
Coming up next, the ability to hide the TiVo on our prize board is getting a little scary. We don't move it around. Someone's going to get it. Wired World Challenge coming up while we rock on.